Faz. Continue the search. The search for secrets left over from the days long gone. Before the end of civilization, as we knew it. In a dying world. In long abandoned ruins. Relics await, well hidden from prying eyes. In our world, there is only radiation, cold, desolation, and death.
Attention, Major. Everything you are about to hear is highly classified. We choose you for this briefing due to your activities in the Central Waste 2 years ago. The information about the asteroid you delivered upon return from Krasnoznamenny greatly agitated the Central Command. Our science teams did not reach a solid conclusion, but all of them agreed that the potential impact of the asteroid would be devastating to all life in the wastes. This is why Central Command organized a special research group with the goals of studying the nature of the problem and finding possible solutions. For the last 1.5 years, the best minds of ATOM worked on this problem. Now it seems that, despite the current state of science and technology in the wastes, a solution has been reached. East of the Central Waste and our base of operations, there is a city called Trudograd. Once it was home to a special strategic manufacturing facility, the Inverter Factory, which was ran by a certain Professor Gorachev. As you know, Trudograd survived the war much better than most cities and towns of our motherland. Thus, it is possible that the facility still stands or even operates, protected by the city walls. This facility is very important to our cause. Before the war, it was used to manufacture an experimental electromagnetic propulsion device, the RR-1 railgun. According to top-secret documents we uncovered during our research, this invention of Professor Gorachev was able to deliver special polymer-based projectiles straight into Earth's orbit, or even further into outer space at tremendous speeds. If this information can be trusted, this device might just happen to be humanity's sole chance at destroying the asteroid before impact. Your mission is to venture into Trudograd, find Professor Gorachev and scout out the inverter facility for any traces of the RR-1 railgun. If the propulsion device will be found, we will take it from there, securing and transporting it to HQ for further study and usage against the asteroid menace. Good luck, Major, and let there be ATOM.
You're sitting in a small clearing in front of a blazing campfire. The autumn forest surrounds you, and it creaks peacefully in the dead of night. The air hangs heavy with the promise of snow and the beginning of winter. The fire crackles softly with the branches that you feed it, enchanted by the darting, dancing flames. Crackling wood and the hiss of boiling sap are the only sounds in your tiny campsite. With a sigh, you stretch your back and gaze over at your surprise guest. He's a short fellow, hunchbacked and raggedly dressed. He emerged from the tall trees about an hour ago and asked if he could warm his bones by the fire. Surprisingly, you disregarded your hard-earned knowledge of the wastes and agreed. Now he's sitting on the opposite side of the fire, his face hidden in the shadows of a hood. His silence is unnerving. You begin to regret allowing the stranger into your camp. Maybe saying something would help ease the tension? The stranger raises his head and looks at you through the flames. At least, it feels as if he's looking at you. His face is still obscured by shadows.
A simple traveler, just like you, he says in a calm and surprisingly soothing voice.
A moment later, he asks,
Did you travel here from far away? As it does to us all.
The man is quiet again, but then throws a dry stick into the flames. Sparks fly up like a cloud of fireflies into the cold heavens as he asks,
Did you hear what happened in Krasnoznamenny? It's a city to the west of here.
You feel a strange urge to tell him the truth. Who knows why? Perhaps telling someone about your adventures will make them more real. Maybe even grant them some kind of meaning.
Good old Adam. Guess those army boys got tired of riding in the backseat.
Stranger adjusts his hood and sinks down into his tattered clothing.
Say, you know what happened to that old Bruiser Dan? Leader of the factory gang. Sad to hear that. Seems like the fate of the Trodnoye, that sweet little village is sealed.
The man shivers slightly. Silence reigns again for a while until a wolf's howl in the distance causes you to look around frantically. Danger lurks in every corner of the wastes, and it pays to be cautious. Why then did you so calmly choose to share your campfire with this odd fellow, a man you know nothing about? As if on cue, the stranger speaks again.
And what happened in the trading hub? Paragon, do you know?
Glad to hear not all is lost in that corner of the wastes. The man stretches his arms up as if to pluck a low-hanging star. Tell me, who did you share your travels with back then? I know it's Bo. I'm so sorry. Anyone else? Once known as Trudov. Yeah, I've heard of him. Anyone else? The worm guy, huh? Is that everyone? The man nods and again gazes down into the fire. You take a drink from your water flask and hold it out to share. He shakes his head no. 5 hard minutes of silence follow until you've had your fill of waiting and guessing. You lean forward, focus exactly on the darkness within the man's cowl, and in a stern voice, ask. Over the years, people have given me many different names, your guest states without emotion. But isn't it true that names, like other words, have no intrinsic meaning? Words are senseless, unless living people recall them and give them purpose. Thus, when we meet again, I will once more become nameless. Of its own accord, your companion's hood slides limply away. But its absence reveals not a human head, but a glowing, undulating sphere of crimson fire. A deadly star. You yelp aloud, for a moment willing yourself to run, but already the night has vanished, dissolved in the haunting red glow. Never again shall you be able to hide from the invisible gaze of your nightmarish guest. That gaze is cruel and indifferent, and the lands it oversees are barren, burnt down to nothing but ashes and splinters of stone. You are so entranced by the endless landscape of utter obliteration that at first you do not notice how your own body has started burning. You are ablaze on the inside, like a bunch of cinders twisted into human form. And the wild, frigid winds scatter your ashes across the surface of the dead earth.
fuck are we?